Go.
Cool. So, KegSwappa keg? iKegger keg. We're going to transfer beer from our KegSwappa keg into our small insulated 19 litre keg. To do that, we put on our A-type coupler, four-lock connections, same as our kegs. We connect the coupler and then connect the gas. Make sure the gas regulator is turned off. You can see that the current pressure is approximately 18 psi. That's in the large keg at the moment. So we're going to bring the small keg back up to the same pressure. And we do that by, we're just going to 18. We're going to disconnect it, undo this so it drops back down to zero again. We will connect it to our small keg. See the pressure going up in the small keg. And we're just going to stop it when it gets to 18. Remove it. Now the two kegs are equal pressure. We will attach our filling kit onto the gas post. We've wound this all the way clockwise to the maximum pressure release point. So no gas is going to come out of that at this point. We then connect the liquid post to the liquid post. Reconnect the gas to the large keg, and now all we do is decrease the pressure that the spunding valve releases at until we start to hear gas coming out. At this point, and we now have, this is actually not beer, it's a seltzer, so it's clear. But we now have wayward seltzer transferring from the large keg into the small keg. So we can hear by, we can speed it up by reducing the pressure here. And once our small keg is full, this ball will float, stopping the flow. Just let it play out. I'll just speed up this bit of footage.
Okay. Might end up a bit wobbly. Might end up looking a bit wobbly.
That's alright. It'll take a while.
should I close in on the filling thing? Should have removed the chair.
Huh?
Should have removed the chair. At least now we know how long it takes to fill a keg.
Beautiful.
Amazing. Can I stop?